tonight.
I was very shocked, just like anybody, I think, that came in contact with Mark.
A local movie producer appears in court tomorrow, accused of acting out his own slasher movie.
I would hear sawing. Sometimes I would walk by and I actually saw like a table saw.
Plus, another tanker truck fatality. And
this is probably the worst thing I've heard.
Kids targeted at a playground.
Live from Edmonton, CTV News with Kevin Armstrong.
Good evening. Mark Twitchell will appear in court tomorrow, charged with first-degree murder. Police believe the 29-year-old filmmaker wrote, produced, and starred in a murder that followed the exact plot line of his latest slasher flick. Scott Roberts reports.
This is the murder site, a garage where police say a slasher screenplay became reality. Now neighbors believe they may have heard some of the plot unfold.
Yes, I would hear sawing. Sometimes I would walk by and I actually saw like a table saw.
Edmonton filmmaker Mark Twitchell has been charged in the death of 38-year-old Johnny Altinger, missing since early October. Investigators say the murder followed the exact storyline of a movie the suspect filmed here last month, right down to a hockey mask used in the slaying.
The movie was about luring a male from a dating internet site and basically killing the male in the garage and chopping up his body parts and getting rid of the body.
The victim went missing after a date set up over the internet. Days later, friends received an email from the victim's account. I've met an extraordinary woman named Jen who has offered to take me on a nice long tropical vacation, an excerpt reads. I won't be back in town until December 10th. Friends knew he didn't write it.
If he meets a girl online, he'll chat with her and get to know her and stuff. But I didn't think he'd be that naive.
Investigators believe the alleged killer was inspired by TV character Dexter Morgan, a fictional serial killer who dismembers bodies.
I've been waiting a long time for this.
The suspect recently wrote about planning and plotting on his Facebook page, saying he was set to evil. CTV News has also learned this stun gun purchased over the internet was recently shipped to his home in St. Albert. Neighbors say his wife has fled.
She's left the house and feels she can never live here again because of reactions from other neighbors, what they must be thinking.
Meantime, those who know the suspect say they never saw it coming.
I was very shocked, just like anybody, I think, that came in contact with Mark. He was friendly and very polite and a very driven young man.
Scott Roberts, CTV News, Edmonton.
Friends and neighbors also tell CTV News Altinger's home was broken into after he went missing. The only thing stolen was his laptop. Again, Twitchler will appear in court tomorrow morning. Outrage and anger tonight for parents in Twilliger Town. It's believed someone left a chemical substance on a piece of playground equipment with the intent to hurt a child. It allegedly happened on Tomlinson Common. A child was rushed to hospital yesterday after playing with a toy telescope on a playground structure. Neighbors tell CTV News when the youngster tilted the telescope up, a chemical of some kind was inside and poured directly into the child's eye and face. The piece of equipment has been removed, replaced with anger in this community.
It's probably the worst thing I've heard in this playground. So it's, we still feel safe in the area. It was kind of a one-off incident, but you still want to make sure that the kids are safe.
Neighbors say the fire department was also spraying down the slides. It's not known if anything was on those slides. Back in June, a two-year-old girl suffered second-degree burns to her legs after she went down a slide that was covered with a toxic substance. That happened at the North Glenora Community Park. Parents say they will be keeping a closer watch on the playground. The condition of the child is not known. For the second time in as many days, police are investigating a fatal crash involving tanker trucks. The single vehicle collision happened just before 5:30 this morning at Anthony Henday Drive, just south of 100 Avenue. Police say the driver of this rig died instantly. The trucker was northbound on Anthony Henday Drive when he veered off the road into a grassy area where he struck a ditch on the south side of 100 Avenue.
The impact caused the trailer to become dislodged from the fifth wheel. It came forward as a result of the momentum and crushed the cab of the tractor.
Traffic analysts believe the driver may have fallen asleep or had a medical condition. The victim's name has not been released. A million-dollar fire in the city's southeast side has left two families homeless. Fire broke out around 3:30 this morning in the Silverberry neighborhood at 33rd Street and 25th Avenue. Witnesses tell CTV News the fire started at this house and skipped to neighboring homes through the fence. Neighbors went door to door, waking up the entire community as flames were spreading quickly.
The tongue of the fire was already seeping through the next house, and we kind of panicked because the wind was blowing that way towards our house.
The fire was contained, but not before it gutted two homes and damaged three others. A friend of one of the homeowners where it's believed the blaze started says reality is now setting in for the couple and their two children.
Just not really knowing what's going on, what to do next, where they're going to go from here. Everything, all of their personal belongings are gone. They are in complete shock.
Families returned to their homes this morning to get whatever they could out, bringing some belongings out in charred suitcases. The Mounties have ramped up their search for BC's natural gas pipeline bomber. So far, three explosions have rocked the community near Dawson Creek. The bomber is believed to know the area well and may be a local. Crews from Encana, the company that owns the pipelines, have been working around the clock to plug the gas leak. A major concern for police is the fact that the attacks are moving closer to populated areas. While residents are afraid for their safety, no one called police after hearing Friday's explosion. Officials at Northland say a horse has died, and it happened during farm fare at Agricom. Officials tell CTV News that a draft horse got sick yesterday and died within hours. It's not clear what caused the death. The horse is now being shipped to a vet college for a postmortem. The horse died in Hall B at the Agricom. It has now been quarantined.
We run a number of livestock shows, so we have some strong protocols around how we deal with livestock in this building. And so when a horse becomes ill and passes on, or any livestock, then we move into some testing so that we understand what we're dealing with.
Officials say that no shows have been canceled. Farm fair runs until November 8th. They're a common sight in England, and soon one of them will be heading up and down our streets in a pilot project. Sherwood Park Transit officials are considering buying a double-decker bus. It would be used to transport passengers to and from Edmonton. The bus seats 80 people, twice the amount of a normal-sized bus.
They're pretty neat. I think it's an attraction. There aren't any in Alberta, so I think it would be interesting if we had the first one in the province.
Strathcona County is testing this double-decker bus for 3 weeks before officials decide whether to buy it. The price tag is around $750,000. One in four people will experience mental illness during their lifetime. Many of those will have a run-in with police. Over the next few days, police officers hope to learn more from mental health professionals at a conference called Psychiatrists in Blue. Officers say they deal with mental ill suspects on a daily basis. Many of them are also dependent on drugs or alcohol. Edmonton has a special crisis team where police and mental health agencies work together.
The problem still remains, though, in remote communities. In our northern communities, communities that don't have a hospital or a mental health facility nearby, it's difficult sometimes for police officers.
The Edmonton Police Service now offers special mental health training during the recruitment stage of an officer's career. Still ahead, raising awareness for the homeless as winter draws near. And just when will those winter temperatures arrive? Your back to work forecast is up next.
This portion of CTV News sponsored by Lubex, saving you time and money on your next lube, oil, and filter change.
When Josh calls it,
Halloween. The trick-or-treaters this year will not be trudging through snow. Mark that, October 15th.
You can count on it. Get Edmonton's most reliable forecast every night on CTV News at 6.
I'm Carrie Dahl with CTV News. Priscilla, Queen of the Dessert, makes her Broadway debut November 10th. Support the Nina Haggerty Center for the Arts at Cakewalk, presented by World Stone. Call for tickets.
Proudly supported by CTV News. It's the biggest sale of the year. On now at The Brick. Line up Saturday for amazing door crasher specials. Get this beautiful micro suede velvet sofa half price. Only $399. Save $1,000 on this special purchase Broy Hill dining room. Get all seven pieces. Half price. Only $999. And you don't pay until 2010. With no down payment, no monthly payments, and no interest. It's The Brick's biggest sale of the year. See more online at TheBrick.com. Don't miss it.
Did you know that hot water and soap don't wash away the fats, oils, and grease you pour down your drain? In fact, they solidify in your pipes, clog your sewer lines, and cause sewage backup in your home and in your neighborhood. The result is time, trouble, and expense for you, your neighbors, and the city. Store your used fats and grease in an empty container like this tin. When it's full, put it in the garbage. Store used cooking oil in an empty jug and set it out for garbage collection. Remember, store it, don't pour it.
A message from the City of Edmonton.
I'm McCormick, and I get it all. You suck, McCormick. You're a bum. Have another donut, McCormick. These are my linesmen. We're into yoga, stress management, and stuff like that. This is our getaway car. It's got performance winter tires from Cal Tire. They'll outrun any angry fan. We're out of here.
True service is a great call.
Cal Tire. True service. The true savings winter sale featuring the Nokia and Hakkapeliitta R ends soon.
People think our prices are at rock bottom. Well, today we show them that this is only the beginning. This is a rollback, people. Remember, only the small survive. Lower, lower. That's it, gentlemen. I like you. You're lower.
Walmart's rolling back the prices on thousands of items.
Now we're rolling.
Are you ready to save?
Hi, this is Terry Evans. Closed captioning of this program is brought to you by Edmonton's classic rock, the legendary K97.
With winter season just around the corner, a local group is trying to raise awareness for our city's housing crisis. The 6th annual Home Fest took place this afternoon, more than 1,000 people taking it in. The event draws attention to the plight facing our city's homeless. I'll
tell you how. Unfortunately, we're falling further behind. In Edmonton, we're building less affordable housing for poor people than the amount of housing that's being lost when places are torn down or when places are converted to condos.
Organizers say more than 2,600 people in our city are homeless on any given night. Preparations are already underway for Christmas. Organizers of Edmonton's Bright Nights Festival were hard at work today. The Christmas light display takes about a month to set up. More than 1.5 million light bulbs are used in the decorations, with roughly 50 to 60,000 bulbs being replaced every year. Organizers want to remind those who show up that it's about more than checking out the light show.
It's a lot of effort every year, but I know that the public really enjoys it, and it's a great cause for donations for the food banks.
Bright Nights opens on November 21st and runs until January 4th at Horlack Park. Well, beginning to look a lot like Christmas in that respect, yeah. But certainly not when you look outside right now.
No. Everything we're looking at is warm temperatures, and anything that's falling is falling as rain. 14 degrees was our daytime high, which is 10 degrees above average. We had a warm day yesterday and a couple above average days before that as well. But what we're seeing is a general slowdown and a slide of temperatures into temperatures more close to the average for this time of year, or even cooler. For the overnight tonight, around Edmonton, 5 degrees. Last night it was 7, so even the overnight lows were above average. But we're keeping an eye up at northwestern Alberta, around high level. There's a freezing rain warning. There were some bad roads on the BC side of things last night. We're expecting some bad roads around the high level region for tonight, so keep that in mind if you're doing any traveling tonight or into the morning as well. Now for tomorrow's daytime highs, a little bit cooler than they were today. We're looking at 8 degrees for Grand Prairie, 7 through Jasper, Grand Cache, Hinton, and Edson. We're looking at clearing for western parts and central parts of the province as we get into the day tomorrow. And then as we go across the northeastern part, we start to see some flurry activity possible and then rain mixed in with there as well. So cooler temperatures in the high level, than 7 through 9 degrees for the rest of the region. Northeastern Alberta, we're seeing cool conditions for Fort Chipewyan, 6 degrees for Fort McMurray, and then 7s and 8s for the rest of the region. Most of the rain showers that push through there throughout the better part of the afternoon should be falling as rain. 9 degrees for Vegreville, 7s for Wainwright, Lloydminster, Provost, Bonnyville, St. Paul, those entire regions. And as we go through the areas around Calgary, Drumheller, Medicine Hat, we're looking at double-digit temperatures, 11 through 13. Warmest is Lethbridge at 17. Tomorrow should be the warmest part of the province. 9 degrees for Camrose, Wetaskiwin, and Drayton Valley, 8 for Rocky Mountain, 10 for Red Deer. Clearing skies there, clearing skies for the Edmonton region, but we will start the day off with some clouds and the possibility of some showers lingering through the first part of the day tomorrow.
breezy conditions as well. The wind's out of the northwest. Cold front is pushing through the province. That will keep things a little bit on the cooler side, cooler than they were today, bringing us those northwesterly winds around that 20 to 30 kilometers an hour mark. Now, Futurecast showing us low pressure system sliding off into Saskatchewan. That possibility still seeing some more showers through the capital region. That pushes off into northeastern Alberta, maybe seeing some flurries up in Saskatchewan, but for the most part, left with rain up in northeastern Alberta later in the day tomorrow. 5-day forecast has tomorrow is the warmest, then cooling off for Tuesday, still above average though. And then for Wednesday night into Thursday morning, we could see there's about a 40% chance of picking up some showers that could turn into flurries, and then we're clearing out on Thursday afternoon, 2 degrees there, 3 for Friday, and then onto the 10-day forecast, rather, and we're looking at temperatures staying cooler than we've been used to for the past several days.
Cooler, but still...
Not horrific.
Yeah.
Just
and
cooler.
Right around on the seasonal,
yeah.
Right?
Like yeah, right around the seasonal mark. You know, right around the freezing mark is getting to be the seasonal mark for this time of year, but when you've been experiencing 15 degrees at the beginning of November, it's quite a difference.
Okay. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
CTV Weather Watch, sponsored by Benjamin Moore. Benjamin Moore designers bring you color ideas and inspiration.
On deck, the Oilers broke a 5-game winless streak yesterday. Could they start a winning streak today? And the puck drops on the World Junior A Hockey Challenge tonight in Camrose, Canada West, hosting Belarus.
I'm McCormick, and I get it all. You suck, McCormick. You're a bum. Have another donut, McCormick. These are my linesmen. We're into yoga, stress management, and stuff like that. This is our getaway car. It's got performance winter tires from Cal Tire. They'll outrun any angry fan. We're out of here.
True service is a great call.
Cal Tire. True service. The true savings winter sale featuring the Nokia and Hakkapeliitta R ends soon.
Why? I learn.
Why? I run.
Why? I volunteer.
Why? I care.
Why? We believe.
We build strong kids, strong families, strong communities. Edmonton's YMCA. Buying a car or truck has never been easier than at Western GMC Pontiac Buick.
Like Pontiac Vibes for only $17,399 or G5s at 0% financing for 5 years.
Visit Western GMC Pontiac Buick today, 184th Street and Stony Plain Road.
AMA is at work in your community with helpful services for travelers such as AMA Road Reports, a commitment to the environment that targets idling and using fuel wisely, supporting traffic safety initiatives such as AMA School Safety Patrol, protecting you and your property through crime prevention programs like Stop Thief. Experience AMA. It all adds up to bringing you peace of mind.
Nothing attracts like new Excel White. The gum that not only freshens your breath, but whitens your teeth while you chew.
I gotta tell you, I was a little bit confused this morning. The clocks changed and everything, and then turn on the TV and there's an Oiler game bright and early this morning.
Isn't Coronation Street supposed to be on Sunday mornings, you know?
Not this morning.
No, it's not supposed to be about entertaining TV. It was today, the second game in as many days for the Oilers. Edmonton and Philly, an early start, 11 in the morning our time. Dwayne Rollison picked up the win in Carolina yesterday. Rolly gets the call again today. First period, Edmonton power play. Robert Nielsen will spot Andrew Cogliano. Nice little move, but Marty Biron comes up in the crease. Flyers shorthanded. Scotty Hartnell for Glenn Metropolitan. Dwayne Rollison the save. Edmonton on the rush. Fernando Pesenny, smart guy. To the net without the puck. Ethan Morrow for Eric Cole. Snipes one. Glove side one. Nothing. Oilers, less than 2 minutes later, Philly strikes on the power play. Mike Knubel, 1-1. It is time to be entertained. Alex Hemsky, a little bit of showtime. That is a top-notch goal. Hemsky's first of the year. He walks around Braden Coburn and burns Biron. 2-1 oil after 1 second period. There is a time to dance. That time would be right about now. Steve McIntyre and Riley Cote trade shots. A very long, very solid tilt. Both men sporting deep cuts as they head to the penalty box. From tough to finesse. Hemsky, back to work.
Aleš Hemsky. Hemsky moving in. Hemsky trying to get it back in. Oh, what a goal! As Aleš Hemsky goes backhand, forehand for his second of the afternoon. It's 3-1 Edmonton. He's putting on a show.
Hemsky does it again, a highlight reel goal. That's why it made the highlight reel pack. 3-1 Edmonton on Hemsky's second of the game. Flyers power play. Coburn rips one past a screen to Wayne Rollison. 3-2, but the Oil come right back. Edmonton power play. Sam Gagner, watch him. Surrounded by Flyers. Nice little move. Then the feed for Sheldon Surrey. 4-2 Edmonton. The goals keep coming. Hemsky drops for Surrey. Dustin Penner is on the rebound. Two goals, 91 seconds apart. 5-2 Edmonton. Edmonton looking to go up by four. Sean Horkoff just wide of the net. Just over a minute to go in the second. Jeff Carter's ninth of the year. Philly's third power play goal of the day. 5-3. Then, just 20 seconds into the third, Philly strikes again. Simon Gagné off a mad scramble in front. It's a 5-4 game. Scotty Hartnell takes a long feed. Duane Rollison comes up big time. Keep your eyes on this puck. Off Steve Staios and into the glove of Duane Rollison. Edmonton holds on to the one-goal lead for the rest of the third. The Oilers skate out of Philly with a 5-4 win. Aleš Hemsky and his two highlight reel goals steal the show. The Oilers pick up their second win in as many days. Tom Gilbert chips in with three assists. Next up, Columbus on Wednesday night. The Flames going for their seventh straight win in Anaheim. Edmonton's darling Chris Pronger makes it 2-0 Ducks. Then Ryan Carter will cash in with a greasy one. Ducks win 3-2. Wings, Canucks, Darren McCarty, Mike Brown. It's a pleasure to watch a tilt like this. Top-notch bout. Late second. Wings power play. Henry Zetterberg. Hank Zetterberg. I like to call him Hank. Game winner. Detroit 3, Vancouver 2. Others call him Henrik. One other Northwest team on the ice tonight. Colorado, they lose 5-3 to San Jose. The Leafs lose in Carolina. And Atlanta, they actually win a game. Their third win of the year, 5-3 over Florida. Western Hockey League tonight. The Edmonton Oil Kings, 5-2 losers in Kelowna. The Oil Kings are in Seattle on Tuesday. The World Junior A Hockey Challenge is now underway in Camrose. Team Canada West, coached by Camrose Kodiaks head coach Boris Rybalka, and Belarus opened up the tournament tonight. Canada West going for their third world title in a row. Second period tied at two. Belarus gets the go-ahead goal. Kirill Brykun from the off wing. Belarus with two goals in the opening 28 seconds of the second to take a 3-2 lead. The lead only lasts 121 seconds. Matt McKay, nice patience, slides it in. 3-3. We go to the third. Still tied at three. Yeheni Salamanu runs out of room. 3-3 after three. We go to a five-minute four-on-four overtime session where Canada West goes on the power play and they cannot find the twine. Canada opens things up by missing in the shootout. Belarus, watch the water bottle. It always tells the tale. That's a nice move. Canada's third shooter, Brody Reed, has to score to keep Canada alive. No, they call it an upset. Belarus 4, Canada West 3. Two more games tomorrow. They start up at 4 in the afternoon in Camrose. NFL will start in the NFC East. The Dallas Cowboys still trying to win without Tony Romo and his broken right pinky. Brad Johnson got the start for the 5-3 boys as they took on the NFC East, leading 6-1 New York Giants. First Sunday nighter, Big Brother Peyton and the Colts taking on the Patriots. Third quarter, Peyton Manning, Anthony Gonzalez's second touchdown of the evening. We go to the fourth quarter. The former Patriot, Adam Vinatieri, 52 yards to win it for the Colts. You know it. Indy wins 18-15. The only undefeated team in the NFL, 7-0 Tennessee, 4-3 Green Bay. Donald Driver, a five-yard major. 10-6 Green Bay in the second quarter. The Titans come right back with a three-yard TD. Chris Johnson takes it in, does a little dance. Late fourth quarter, tied at 16. Rob Baronis from 47 yards for the win. Off the upright, we go to overtime. Baronis gets the Spectrum winless Detroit and the 4-3 Bears. Darren Orlovsky, Calvin Johnson, 17 yards, 13-10. Lions, second quarter, Lions up by 10. Watch Kyle Orton's right foot. He injures his ankle. Orton in bad shape. He has to leave the game. But Bears backup quarterback Rex Grossman does it up in style. Gets the game-winning one-yard touchdown in the fourth. Chicago with a 27-23 win. The Bears now alone in first in the NFC North at 5-3. Tampa Bay and Kansas City, the Bucs at 5-3. Need a win to keep pace with the 6-2 Panthers who are off this week. This won't help. Trick play. Look who catches the ball. The quarterback, Tyler Thigpen. Like it a lot. A 37-yard major. 21-3 Chiefs of Kansas City. Fourth quarter, the Bucs coming back. They get funky. Ernest Graham lets it go for Alex Smith. 24-19. 25 seconds left. Bucs down by 8. Jeff Garcia scrambles. Out of the pocket. Lets it fly for Antonio Bryant. The Bucs had a two-point convert. We're tied at 27. We go to overtime. In OT, Matt Bryant wins it. Buccaneers 30. Chiefs 27. NFC West leading Arizona Cardinals in St. Louis. Mark Bulger, not as planned. Antrell roll with the interception. He has eyes for the end zone. He tiptoes in. 7-7. 53 seconds to go in the first half. Kurt Warner uses his old man powers to tee St. Louis. Is this an interception? No! So close into the arms of Jeremy Urban. He walks in. Arizona wins 34-13. Scores the Bills, Jets, and Patriots because of this win. Now all tied at 5-3. A three-way tie for top spot in the AFC East. Baltimore 37, Cleveland 27. The Eagles all over Seattle. The Falcons jumped to 5-3. Miami, a 500 team in the AFC East after that win over Denver. Minnesota 28, Houston 21. And believe it, the Cincinnati Bengals pick up their first win of the year. 21-19 over the Jags. They had to win sometime.
Cincinnati killed me in the pool this week.
You took Cincinnati?
No. And that's why I'm dead.
That's right. I took the Bears. They beat the Giants. That's why I'm still alive.
All right. We'll be right back.
CTV Sports, sponsored by the Edmonton Subaru Dealers Partial Zero Emission Vehicle, the alternative to hybrids.
Why do we ride? Because our sweat is nothing compared to their tears. Our challenge, nothing compared to their fight. Because we are all on one journey with one destination, one goal, to conquer cancer. Register for the Ride to Conquer Cancer benefiting the Alberta Cancer Foundation. A two-day cycling journey for all abilities along the majestic Canadian Rockies. Start a new cycle of change. Finish cancer. Sign up now at 888-624-BIKE or conquercancer.ca.
Is your car ready for winter?
Visit Midas for tires and all your car care needs. Right now at Midas, with the purchase and installation of 4 tires, you'll receive a free winter maintenance package. Be safe. Trust the Midas touch.
It's the wildest ticket in town, because when the action comes alive, it gets out of control real quick. We're talking unpredictable entertainment at its best. Don't miss Canadian Finals Rodeo, where the West turns and turns, and turns, and turns wild. Get your tickets now at CanadianFinalsRodeo.ca or Ticketmaster.
I've always said you can trust Mountain Tire because the owners run the store. Now I'm driving store to store to show you. You see, as owners, they have a vested interest in making sure you're happy. Hey, where the heck is the owner anyway?
He's in the service bay.
Makes sense.
At Fountain Tire, the owners run the store, so you know they're committed to giving you the best service possible.
Anything I can do to...
No, he's good.
Oh, gosh. Good call. Evidently, you've seen my work.
Finally for us tonight, the U.S. election is just 2 days away. Cheesy campaign slogans are common, but campaign cheese a bit different. An Oklahoma artist managed to print photographs of presidential candidates on his cheese.
On his cheese. Very nice.
Very nice. Who are you calling in that one? Sports guy?
Can't get political.
See ya.
Okay.